You've seen several commands, like ls, uptime, and cause, that do something and then immediately return you to the shell prompt. But not all programs do that. Some programs are a little bit more interactive. They take over the terminal for as long as they're running, and then you get the shell back when the program exits. Take, for instance, ping. Ping lets you test whether another machine on the internet is alive, and how long it takes to send a message to that machine and back. Let's say you ping 8.8.8.8, which is Google's public DNS server, very fast and well-connected, so we should always be able to get to it. Ping starts, and it prints out a line for each successful echo, but it doesn't stop on its own and give you your shell back. Instead, you have to tell it to stop. One of the most common ways to tell a program like this to stop is to type Control C, which sends the interrupt signal. When you do that, ping stops, prints out a summary, and you get your shell prompt back. But some programs have a different behavior. There's a really common design in Linux programs where a program will read from what's called standard input, or stdin, and write to what's called standard output, or stdout. This allows programs to be chained together under a pipeline, which is a little bit beyond the scope of this course. But when you run a program like this from the terminal, it'll read from your keyboard input and write back to the terminal screen. And very often, when your input is done, you want to send it an end-of-file character, which you do by typing Ctrl-D. Here's an example, the sort program, which sorts lines in alphabetical order. If you run sort and then type or paste in some text, it will print those lines out sorted. But it can't do any sorting until it's received the last line. And that's what typing Ctrl-D tells it. You have to use Ctrl-D instead of Ctrl-C if you want the sorted output. Ctrl-C will just cause it to exit. But there we go. There are the four lines that I typed in, sorted. Programs like sort are called line-based programs because they read input one line at a time until they reach the end of the input. You can usually use them on files as well as on text that you type in or paste into the terminal. You'll see a few more of them later in the course.